You've just broken your collarbone and you don't know how to sleep or lie in your bed. Stay tuned, I've got you covered. I'm currently injured. I crashed pretty hard yesterday and my wrist is... But staying on the topic of injuries and crashing and that kind of thing, I want to talk about my collarbone that I broke a few years ago. I got a popular video on my channel regarding my collarbone. And I get a ton of questions on there. So maybe we can talk about it more because obviously there's a lot of people struggling out there with a broken collarbone. And this seems to be an injury that happens more often than we would like. Now, collarbone is a super uncomfortable place to break something. And maybe my healing process and my experience that I had from my broken collarbone can help one or two of you out there who are watching this video. A couple of years ago, I broke my collarbone. That's pretty much what it looks like now. It's like this big lump. It's healed up. I didn't have surgery. That was a pretty hectic experience that I had, and it was traumatic. And I remember the healing process pretty vividly. These were the best practices that I found helped with my healing process. Just know this, that I am not a doctor. This was my own personal healing process and the things that I figured out while I was healing. If you are having complications or experiencing any pain or discomfort, definitely go check your doctor. Sleep is a massive part of the healing process. Our bodies need to rest up as much as possible. And I found that sleeping with a broken collarbone was extremely uncomfortable. I've got a queen bed at home and just the open space there, it just caused massive discomfort because I was moving around. I think I slept on the bed one night and then I moved. I'll be tossing and turning and moving around all the time at night. So I figured that maybe if I moved to a couch, I'd be moving around less and it would be helping me with my healing process and much more comfortable, which it was. This video was sponsored by my patrons. If you like my channel, you like the videos, you like the content, you wanna help out, head on over to my Patreon account for a couple of bucks a month. So a big shout out and thank you to my patrons. Let's move over to my couch area quickly and I'll explain to you exactly what I mean. That is basically where I spent around about 11 weeks of recovery. Now, the main problem with sleeping in my queen size bed in the bedroom was that I was moving around a ton. Just couldn't find a place where I was comfortable. And then I thought about it and I was like, you know what? I need a stable place where I can actually rest my shoulder that will prevent me from turning. And that is why the couch was my solution. This backrest became like a stopper and the resistance from that prevented me from tossing and turning at night. I could lie on my back and just remain in that one position the whole time. And the nice thing about sleeping on the couch is that the remote control is over there and the TV is right over there as well. So I could enjoy watching TV for a long time on this couch, keep me occupied and amused without having to move around too much. There was one essential trick that made this technique of sleeping the best. The fucking pillow. I'd wedge myself into a nice corner on the couch, place the pillow up against the backrest of the couch so the pillow won't move at all, and then my arm would rest on the pillow like that, and it would basically be like I was constantly in a sling. So I would get maximum healing time with minimal movement. And the backrest of the couch prevents me from rolling over on that side of the shoulder. And it's also preventing the pillow from moving out from underneath my arm. When I'm lying in the bed, there's nothing that's keeping the pillow in place. During the night, the pillow would just slip out and move from underneath my elbow. I didn't have any fancy figure of eight sling that was tied around. I only had a normal sling. That is the way that I slept for 11 weeks of healing. I know it's a couch and it's like super weird and stuff to sleep on the couch for 11 weeks, but hey, you know what? I healed up really well. Hit that subscribe button if you like the channel, that bell to be notified every time I drop a video. If you have any questions, you want more of these videos about my recovery process while I was healing from a broken clavicle, leave it in the comment section below. Like this video and share it with all your pals. Maybe this video can help out another person with a broken clavicle that is suffering and struggling to sleep at night. Thank you very much for joining me on this episode, and I will catch you on the next one.